supposed to be a 2.
You have you opened package 2, Lamb?
Yes.
Okay, good. I'm throwing all the rule stickers in a nice big pile here, and then someone else can deal with that.
Alright, stream is live, and seems to be okay.
Well, that's fun.
There we go.
Yeah, we're only up to 20% CPU usage, so...
My Amish, too. Able to cope.
So, for the purposes of anybody joining us for the stream, we may have lost our save file. So we're now trying to recreate the game state from my terrible 540p YouTube upload from last time we played, which was nearly a month ago.
Montreal is at 3.
Yeah. Some of the blue cities ended up getting a little bit angry.
Well, no, not angry, just, you know...
No, that's 2.
Hungry for brains.
It's 2. It's yeah. The bad resolution.
Yeah.
I think we only have, like, one city in 3, and it's not...
Yeah, was it...
It's not in America.
Moscow or Miami? Yeah, I think I have a bad tendency of trying to play with the full board in view as well, which doesn't lend itself to seeing detail very easily. So while that goes on, I'm just going to quickly refill my glass of water. I'm sure everybody else will entertain you with their bickering about what names all the characters had.
Oh, I don't remember
the surname of the pilot. I just remember his first name was Chester.
I mean, that shouldn't be a problem.
Oh, this friggin' legacy card, this is going to take a while.
Or is that the one with about 6,000 things to open?
No, not 6,000, just 10. Still entirely too many. It doesn't help that these sticker sheets are not laid out in any sort of sensible order.
Nope.
That's right, we've just got an equipment.
Yes.
Lamb, can you turn off hands?
Yes.
Okay, so where is R? R, here is R. Open package 3, I assume Lamb's already done that, since that's open.
Huh. I just dropped my action cards through the table.
Yeah, that happens.
I don't know how to get them back.
Karachi's a 2. I don't think, actually, I forget, if I remember correctly, we didn't actually get any to 2. We fought, or to 3. I think we fought one was at 3, and then it wasn't. Because we had miscalculated stuff.
Yeah.
Riyadh.
There we go.
Johannesburg.
Oh, that's right. We thought one had gone to 3, and then we ran out of cities to outbreak before that could happen.
Yeah. Sydney. Manila.
Okay, that's the letters. Now we move on to numbers.
That's right, we're up to state 4, because we now have equip available.
Oh, yeah, I was going to go through these in order, but...
Sorry, I was just getting my personal area set up.
It seems no one else cares, so whatever.
Yeah. San Fran.
I'm not joining in on the main setup in case I interfere with anybody else. So.
Washington. And that should be all, I think. Chicago has
one. Did you find the sticker sheet, Lamb? Because the faded city stickers, like, that's a thing.
That's in one of the
there it
packages.
Is.
Because New York was definitely ground zero.
Yeah, and I think actually relationships are going to be the hard part. The resolution is too bad.
Yeah.
I know. The researcher has rivals. No, he has co-workers.
Co-workers.
Yeah, he was co-workers with the scientist, wasn't he?
No,
with Quarry.
Quarry, that's it.
And the operations expert was rivals.
With the scientist.
With the scientist.
The scientist had a scar.
Scientist was...
One or two scars. I don't remember.
One.
I'm going to put all the stuff I find that needs to be deleted like up here in the corner.
I'm adding a ton of bags for things that need to go in bags.
Yep.
That's right. New York never hasn't right the fact that it is ground zero for CODA.
Yeah, it doesn't really care.
Yeah, like, it's New York.
New York, basically everyone in New York is like, oh, whatever.
This is unfunded event stickers, and I don't know where the rest of them are. There they are, in this bag.
Yeah.
That was 16. Was that all that was in 16? Yes. Okay.
Where are city markers? There they are.
One thing's still missing. I still haven't found the CODA figure bag, which is odd, because I just processed all the stuff in the CODA card.
You mean this one?
Yeah, Lamb's already retrieved that.
Oh, yeah. Lamb, stop doing things.
No, I retrieved that when I opened them the first time.
Yeah, stop doing things. Like I said, stop doing things
but
that I
been
am
doing.
I've
been doing things for, well, a while now. So...
Yeah, see, that's the problem. P, where the fuck is P?
I think basically every... City is. I can't see if Miami's supposed to
There's
be or
B.
not on this picture.
This looks like a rule sticker.
I'm pretty sure Miami had faded.
No, Miami doesn't actually. It's still quarantined.
Ah.
So Miami somehow survived? Against all odds, Miami survived from being faded.
Oh, sorry, yeah, it was. Sao Paulo was the rando one, wasn't it? Because of the.
Maybe Miami's just so used to people biting that they're like, whatever. It's like they don't report on it because it's nothing out of the ordinary.
Yeah.
Madrid.
I do not remember that we had a research station in Istanbul and one in Ho Chi Minh that I think we kept.
Essen.
And I think we kept...
St. Petersburg.
Did we keep a military base somewhere?
Yeah, we have military bases that we kept somewhere.
We have one in Istanbul, and then one in Chicago.
Yeah, that was our way of getting through the North American roadblock, wasn't
one
it?
One in Hong Kong.
Oh yeah, that's right, because the research station is in Ho Chi Minh, but the...
Oh. No, wait, we built the Chicago one during that session. Doesn't exist.
That's right, we didn't keep it. Yes.
Yeah, so it's Istanbul and Hong Kong.
Yeah.
Right.
42. Where the...
Do we have the permanent roadblock markers?
Somewhere. They're coming. I'm going through that bag, those ones right now. I'll get to them eventually.
And...
Was that all that was in 42? Yep, so advance to state 3, but someone else has already put...
Wait, where's the research station marker? Or the... Well, also those. Research station markers and the other one.
Yeah, they're the two grey bags on the rank of 8. So sort of the starting ones.
The military base permanent markers.
Ah.
We've
only got the military bases so far.
42.
They're probably in the bag with the military bases.
25. Oh, 25 contains a couple more relationships.
Yep. I think we ended up having a bag for those.
Yeah, I made some extra bags here.
Yeah, the relationships are in a pile there. Someone wants to bag those. That's cool.
Let's see. See if I can get a better view of those permanent roadblocks. Go up. Go up.
Permanent roadblocks.
Yeah, you'll find as you watch the video that I'm really not very good at the camera control.
No, I got him.
I had a habit of mostly keeping it.
No, that's a regular roadblock. Oh, yeah. This is not the end of the game yet. I remember at least that Tokyo, Manila, and Sydney are... Oh, wait, no. Tokyo, Manila, Sydney are the ones that are blocked off.
Yeah. Did we keep the permanent ring around San Francisco, or did we just keep the ones on the outer edge?
Just the outer edge.
No, because we only did the Pacific Rim.
Yeah.
Gotta keep my hometown safe, damn it.
Wow. So you know they announced Kaladesh for Magic the Gathering yesterday?
Yes.
Mark Rosewater's hinted that the set contains a mechanic he's been trying to make work for some time. Mm-hmm. So everybody is assuming he's finally solved contraptions and is now speculating on Steam Flogger Boss. So it is skyrocketing in price.
Twice as many contraptions here.
I like how it's skyrocketing in price because everyone can't just wait to see what it is.
Yeah. Well, I mean, okay, it's not due out until autumn. Spoilers aren't going to start till like
September. I am deleting them now.
Yeah, here on the right side of things as well, there's just a pile of stuff.
I'm pretty sure there's supposed to be more open things.
No, because I just went through the whole deck.
Okay.
We are only halfway through.
True. Which means this game is going to throw even more bullshit at us.
Yeah. It's only going to get harder before it gets easier.
I'm still wondering where those permanent road blocks are.
Did we discover that there was like a package that it told us? That it was one of those where it didn't tell us to look in the package again.
I think
was
it might
package
have...
six?
No, six was the one we accidentally opened. I'm pretty sure in that case it's five.
It'd be worth just having a look in there, but that's got eight things in it, so...
I'm gonna give it a peek.
Okay, Lamb, have a look.
It's not. And I have no idea. I have no idea what any of those things meant, so...
Oh no, package 6 was when we accidentally opened that had all the dossiers in.
Yeah.
It's not package 7, it's definitely not package 8.
And we're missing also military bases.
Military bases. We've got the bases,
here.
But we don't have
the
starting markers.
The permanent.
Yeah, the permanent markers, that's what we're missing, I think. That's all we're missing. I'm pretty sure.
Sure you didn't miss opening anything?
I'm pretty sure. I went through all the cards.
Yeah, it's that there was somewhere there was like a sticker to say.
Do you still have all the cards?
Yeah, this is like the pile of most of the things.
Because we had that early on, didn't we, where we found there was a package that was missing a sticker that it should have had. Although I think he did actually add that in because I complained about it.
Yeah, he did.
This is crap that can be deleted, by the way. All this stuff that's piled here on the side. Including this empty bag.
Had we deleted any packages on the at the end of the game? Can we see which packages are there and which ones are missing?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, wait. Let me check.
Pretty sure we deleted the ones we'd opened at some point, yeah.
Yeah, I'm checking...
This is surely a very interesting stream.
Yes.
We're up to... Wait. How many boxes?
There's eight boxes.
Yeah, there's supposed to be four boxes left that we haven't opened. Let's see if you can give...
That is the case.
Let's see if you give us a good view of the dossier ever in this video.
Probably not.
No, you're not.
I was having some computer issues in that video, so I was keeping the camera movements to a bit of a minimum.
Yeah, you never looked at the dossiers.
No.
Well, dang.
Okay, let's go through. Where's the one where we get Roblox?
Hold on.
Wasn't it... We didn't get them at the beginning of that game. We got them at the end of that game.
The Roblox?
Yeah. We got the Roblox, but we didn't get the permanent Roblox markers.
No, we got them before setting up the next game. And then at the end of that game, before getting endgame, you get the...
Yeah, well, check the when.
It's March.
Yeah, so just before the first game in April, then.
Yeah, that one.
Probably doesn't help that we're all going through this at the same time, because we're idiots.
It's supposed to be the... Before you select end game upgrades in April.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be that one.
At the end of your first game in April, then.
No, I mean May. It must be. May. It should be May, not April.
But there are no cards here that have to do with May. What the fuck?
It's first game. It's April.
There is one over here, which is May's mission briefing.
Yeah.
All right. That is probably it then. Yeah.
So
check those.
No, there should be one more that tells us where the what to get at the end of. Wait. Games. Legacy. Do they have? Do they let me spawn this?
Yeah, I see what you mean about these are just not in any sensible order at all.
Yeah, I don't know who made this.
I mean, we've done 42. February.
P20H, all done. I's done.
That's kind of February. Deliberate 22, to do it that way.
25 March. And 26 are done. So yeah, these ones that are listed on the main mission briefing, those March. We've done.
April. Yeah. First game, selecting April. Oh, that's that one.
Because we haven't found the rules about permanent roadblocks either.
May. And this is all that. At the end of your first game in May, open the following door, 8.
Oh, did I miss that?
Yes, you did. Here they are.
Uh-huh. Alright.
Pretty sure it was the end of that, so...
Yeah, you must have missed the ones with the ones for...
But that's weird because I didn't
military bases as well.
I didn't delete anything.
But if you flipped them, so 21 and 22 maybe.
Carry on.
If you had them all flipped over.
21 and 22, do I have that?
Yeah, we haven't grabbed those, so that is...
Oh, there we go.
Starting military base markers. So and you can 21. Delete those two doors. There's lots in 21.
Yeah, some character upgrades.
There, I thought we were missing stuff.
That's right, because that has the upgrade we gave to the medic, doesn't it? The cure in a nearby city.
Which one's the character upgrades?
In my helmet, probably was because the box is on the front of the card. You missed those.
But no, like I didn't delete any cards. That's not a thing I can do.
No,
so
but
where
you
the fuck those cards go?
You were looking at the side that normally has all the text on, rather than the side that says stop.
Yeah, but
some of them have got the doors on the stop side.
Look at this pile here. Yeah. I haven't deleted any cards,
yeah.
So it's this win bonus one that I missed. That's where the fault is.
It's all fixed, so.
Now let's get rid of all this crap.
So we think we're pretty accurate for the state of the board.
Now we just need to fix the characters.
Yeah. So I was pretty certain we had a couple of military bases for starting with, which we obviously haven't put down because of the lack of markers.
There's one in Hong Kong.
And one in Istanbul.
And one in Istanbul, yeah.
This is where we check the rules and find we couldn't have one of each in the same city.
And then there's permanent roadblock markers on here, here, and here.
Okay, so the scientist had a scar on her.
I haven't seen anything in the quick rules that says you can't have multiple structures in one city.
Yeah, it's probably
It's difficult to do in one game because you have to discard the card to build there normally.
I know I had the scar that meant... Was it that I couldn't leave a city that had cubes in it? Let me have a look through the scars.
Does anyone remember what upgrade we threw on the scientist?
The scientist was rivals with the...
Yeah, that builder. I know, but we
when
threw an upgrade
did we have
on her.
The scientist in a game since the start? I don't remember actually giving her an upgrade, because I don't remember using
her. We gave her an upgrade when we gave the builder an upgrade.
I had regretful. Discard a card every time you leave a city with three cubes of the same color.
I'm pretty sure the researcher had a scar.
Did the researcher have the discard one?
So the scientist definitely had a discard one. The researcher may have also grabbed that.
Yeah, okay, I put the scar on the scientist.
Yeah.
Let's see if we can get... I'm trying to find a good shot of the characters. The
specialist had rivals with someone as well as... co-workers.
Researcher has an upgrade, which is forecaster.
Yeah. All right. Regretful. There we go. I'm glad I figured out how to actually search these things now. That's right, because I took regretful because I got stuck in Moscow and that didn't end so well.
So, are there multiple rivals with relationships? Yes. Good.
Yep.
So I know that I had rivals with someone, but I don't remember who.
Okay.
And by I mean the quarantine specialist.
Yeah. I do like that we've all come very attached to these characters.
Yeah. The scientist is... She exists.
Wait, there should be a good... some good shots of real characters. Here we go.
Somewhere. Didn't we play a game with the Colonel as well?
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, he has
a relationship.
He has rivals with somebody, if I remember correctly.
Then it has to be a rival with Quarry.
Quarry has two relationships.
Yes,
so
she's got co-workers and rivals. And I had co-worker on her, and then someone pinched it.
And... The researcher is supposed to have a scar, which is the one where I have to just... Let's see, I have to go through them, because I will know which one it is. Search.
Hey, I figured out how to use joints.
Ooh. I haven't figured out how to shrink things.
Oh yeah, it was Insomniac, which is reduced my hand limit by one. Just like, yeah I'm never going to have cards in my hand anyways.
Yeah, you're always going to be trying to give them away.
How do you scale things?
Plus and minus. And otherwise, there was not that many other relationships. I think
because it's every time we got a new character, and our characters had been operations expert, quarantine specialist, and the Colonel.
Okay, I've discovered a flaw. I don't think there's any way to remove a joint.
Just
tap it with join.
Hey, Jack.
The The dispatcher doesn't have a scar, and he has two upgrades.
Oh, I thought I'd gained the scar from being stuck in Moscow.
I cannot find anything that supports your claim of the dispatcher having a scar.
Fair enough. Take it off then. I could have sworn.
What upgrade?
I could have sworn somebody had taken that scar. I know he had pilot.
Yeah. Wait, I'm just trying to find where you're actually at your side of the table. Here you're taking a scar. There we go. Yeah, he does have a scar. Yep. But he does also have two upgrades.
Ooh, what's the other second upgrade then?
I have no idea. It's pilot and it's something else that lets you travel really easily.
Yeah, I do not remember at all.
And remove this and this because I can't use them.
Well, not at the moment. They may become relevant later.
We may need to get the scientist, the researcher, archive access. Increase your hand limit by one card. Local pressure. If you're in a military base, you may quarantine in an adjacent city. We need to probably get that on quarry. Veteran, you may take the military shuttle flight action. Was that the one we gave them?
Don't think so.
It's certainly not grizzled, or we wouldn't have gotten the scar.
Did anyone get flexible?
That might be the other one. For an action, discard a card to draw a card of the same color from the player discard pile.
I think that's the one you had. That's the name rings a bell.
In that case, I wasn't using that at all because I'd forgotten about it completely. Because that would be very useful for some of our we need to research stuff.
I seem to remember there being permanent roadblocks somewhere near Moscow as well.
Yeah, I think we made one here and one here permanent.
Where's all the equipment?
Yeah, that's a good question. I think that comes with the next legacy card.
Oh, right.
That we haven't drawn yet.
We got the rules for it, didn't we? We had looked at it because we kind of spoiled it at the end last session.
Yeah, because we did as we usually do, and like was like, let's see what we get next month.
Yeah.
Can I get the rule book out again? Put it over here. Over at all the rules.
Yep. Have we got the big sheet of upgrade stickers as well somewhere? Because we had that.
That was the thing I made.
Ah, right, okay.
Do we still want that?
It was handy, but now that I know how search works, that's not a problem.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking as well. It doesn't seem like it's super relevant anymore.
Yeah. So, as we've got a couple of actual viewers now, our save file disappeared, so we're having to recreate the board state from last week's YouTube video.
Pretty sure it's all recreated now.
Yeah, it looks right now.
I'm pretty sure we're
missing two permanent roadblocks around Moscow.
I love the fact that you've put some of the rioting stickers upside down so they look like fives.
Yeah. There's one thing that I missed from the YouTube video. I need to go back and look at.
How did Milan avoid being faded?
I'm pretty sure it is supposed to be faded.
Milan? Yeah, I remember it getting.
Yeah, Milan is faded
last time.
I must just have forgotten to put a sticker there.
Pretty sure, yeah. Every blue city has now got a faded sticker.
And a few non-blue cities.
Yes. Well,
I presume Lam's going through and joining all these to the board, so we don't worry about accidentally picking them up.
Locking them should be sufficient.
Yeah, I'd never figured out how you do that.
Just hit L.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Yeah, Milan is faded.
Yep.
lock these two roadblocks in place. And I think that's our port stay.
The big question is, did we lose last month or when?
We lost one, then 1-1.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're moving on to June.
We do have the June upgrade.
Yeah.
Or the June bonus.
On the board, that does not restrict us to legal positions for roadblocks.
Yeah. I put a roadblock between Lagos and Algiers.
I'm thinking Cairo. I'm thinking Cairo, Istanbul, and Baghdad, actually.
Doesn't that mean our funding is back at zero?
It is back
at zero. Yes.
We don't have the funding tracker piece of paper.
I'm making a new one. Here we go.
Okay, so do we pull the next setup card then and start setting up for June?
Yeah, I think we need to.
Whoop. Okay, we've got a bunch of things to open.
And now we get the soldier and the car and the stuff, right?
Yeah, now we get the equipment. Okay.
We have someone who can take out infected in countries that do not have a military, or zones that do not have a military base.
Yes, so we could run a double soldier for this one if we wanted to.
I mean colonel and soldier.
That's what I mean, yeah, colonel and soldier, because then they can both do.
I'm going ahead and opening all the things, by the way.
Yeah, yep. Go for it.
And finding more things for Lamb to delete.
Here's the equipment bag.
Was 46.
We had, was it grenades was one of the equipment I remember?
Yeah, grenade belt. Right.
And yeah, you get equipment by visiting a city with a military station.
And then you attach it to a card?
Yeah, you put equipment on a card. It's like in funded events.
Okay, so, I'm digging out all the equipment from the places they're hiding.
So basically, basically turn city cards into multipurpose. I forget, is there in the player deck, is there one of each city?
Yes.
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, so that does mean that it would always be the same one.
Yeah.
Because I remember saying like how you do the unfunded stuff is basically just note what it's supposed to be.
And there's a description to that card.
Yeah, and I also believe it. You cannot put an unfunded event and equipment on the same card.
That makes sense.
Is there any actual rules to discuss this? The equipment ones, hopefully? Each city card can only have one sticker.
Yes.
Yeah.
I believe that rule was already with the unfunded events, because that's probably in the book, so.
Yeah, it's probably in the book somewhere. Which has a lot of text. And a lot of places where the stickers are supposed to go, but yeah.
Yeah, but we don't have a rule book to put them in.
So we just pile them on the table. Like the scrubs that we are.
It would be quite entertaining if we tried to attach them, because as you flip the state for each page, it would leave the stickers still on top.
Each city card can only have one sticker.
Okay, I haven't seen anything that says we are supposed to remove any of these objectives, so we still have these four objectives, and we still need to complete three of them.
Yep.
Yeah. I mean, eradicate is pretty... have we put the...
No, we don't have the disease upgrades on yet.
So, yeah, red is supposed to be on both on having two upgrades.
So red has common structure and efficient sequence.
Yep.
Yep.
And yellow has common structure.
Yeah.
Game, let me pick these up, please.
Why is that green? It should be blue.
All right. Don't worry about it.
It's mutated to green because that's the color of the faded, so.
There we go.
Yeah, I'll accept that.
The virus previously known as the T-virus.
Okay, the game's being really stingy with me picking these up for some reason.
There you go.
No, but if Coda is the actual T-virus, shouldn't Black be like Las Plagas?
Probably, but that was Black was T-virus until Blue became Coda, and then that's why it was the virus formerly known as the T-virus.
There we go. Las Plagas.
One of them was Pax Flu, and I forget which one.
It's yellow. Because the red was Red Menace.
Yep.
And now, hopefully, we have the board state.
So, character setup. What characters are we going to use?
We have the soldier now here in the pile as well.
Do we need to pick characters before we do the setup? Can we see which cities get infected for our starting scenario?
I believe so, yes.
Shall we do that then?
Might be worth checking the rule setup for just what order things happen.
Yep.
I know you set up before you determine your starting city.
In the mission medium, set up board and pieces, play as out, base like fun, and prepare player decks, select characters.
Yeah, step four is...
So prepare the board, then select characters. We do basically everything before we select characters. Right. Let's get to it then.
Oh no. Four, place infection rate marker and infect 9 cities. So yes. That's done before 7. So yes. So let's do that first.
We ain't funded for shit.
Yeah. So while you do that,
everyone draws their cards.
Too damn good at our job.
Board setup happens first, Lamb.
It doesn't matter.
Well, Lamb can be doing that while we infect.
Yeah, like, drawing cards doesn't matter before setup.
Okay, who wants to infect the first three?
Me.
You're too slow.
You monster.
Ooh.
Well, that's some yellow.
And some blue.
It would matter if this affected accelerated incubation, but it doesn't.
Some zombies up in Chicago.
3 on Bogota.
And 3 on LA, which is more zombies, actually.
Yep.
I really hate the zombies because they refuse to stack properly. Keep falling over. This annoys me greatly.
Wait, 3 on Los Angeles?
Yep.
Oh, because it was yellow, so it's like, yeah, we're fine.
I
shuffled this a lot. we may be running
Lamb,
2 soldiers.
This is your fault.
I did not actually touch that deck, so it's not my fault. Actually, that might make it my fault.
This is your fault.
It is Lamb's fault.
It's my fault for not shuffling it.
Well, I'm guessing we're not starting in Atlanta then.
No.
That's correct.
Instant scar for everybody.
Depends if Radico is the one who starts, so he can quarantine and take a scar.
Santiago,
Beijing, and Tokyo.
That's not too bad.
There's something lying on top of Tokyo. By something, I mean the pile of epidemics.
The epidemics. Oh, God.
Alright. Tokyo is currently experiencing a massive epidemic.
We need to draw before you split them, Lamb.
Yeah, I've done that
already. Oh, you've done that for us. Aha. Manila and Atlanta. Okay.
Oh, woo. Chicago and Essen. The best and most useful cards.
Tehran and Buenos Aires.
I mean, I would love to build a base or something in Chicago, except that seems like a terrible plan.
Well, it depends.
I don't want to go there.
So you're saying you don't want to go?
I don't want to go.
Oh, I forgot about that. When drawing player cards, check if any city matches the color of Coda. So basically,
that's only...
when we draw for turn, if we draw a blue one, it gets another faded. I had forgotten about that.
We should just delete the blue cure marker.
We don't know if we need it yet, so I'm going to leave it there.
Put it in the faded city markers or something.
But no, then we might
actually... I'll put it in the blue cubes box.
Yep. Which is tiny.
I made it tiny, because it's irrelevant.
At the moment.
It's irrelevant, much like its size.
Okay, so character choices.
Yeah, and then starting location as well.
Let's line up our characters.
We have the colonel and soldier as well.
I think...
Colonel Kling.
I think...
Does anyone remember what we named the colonel?
He's named Colonel Stryker.
Yes.
Oh, right, yes. Because... Right.
You named him, didn't you? And the soldier... No one has picked the soldier yet, so he doesn't have a thing. And we also have the generalist, but really...
The generalist is basically there for when you run out of other characters. Well, that's the civilians, isn't it? Is the last ditch.
The generalist is so you have someone who still can do something better before you end up with civilians.
Yep. I would say the colonel and quarry are probably essential.
Yes, so... Oh, but we...
But do we need the soldier?
I'm is the sure colonel the or soldier. The soldier better?
Yeah. The soldier needs an equipment card.
The soldier can hang around dealing with faded.
Yeah, but he needs an equipment card.
Equipment. And we haven't set up any equipment yet, so he need to equip things first.
Yeah, he need.
I
he
will
need
be the quarantine specialist.
The soldier also can't actually deal with faded. He just doesn't get a scar for being in faded cities.
Yeah, he needs equipment to deal with.
He needs the
grenade belt.
Yeah, he needs the grenade belt, and then you can put him in a city, and then you can just cycle that card forever to destroy people. But the colonel can just destroy them instantly for an action.
Yeah. The key thing is just that he needs to leave that city if more show up.
Yeah, if the colonel comes into a faded city, he can use all his action to just kill faded.
But there's a military base in the region. We need a military base in the region.
Yeah.
Yeah. But the soldier has to use an action to pick up the belt again.
Yeah.
So he can, as max, destroy two. Yeah.
Well, I say the colonel is better. If it starts off the right way. But yeah.
Yeah, Salty Bob was the operations expert because Ranico was annoyed because he couldn't.
It was Salty Bob, the operations expert.
Yeah, because you wanted to just call him operations expert, and we renamed him Salty Bob.
I named him Salty Bob. Thank you very much, because he is very salty.
So, yeah, I think Colonel and Quarry are probably essential.
Yeah, and we've got Quarry already, so who wants to...
I think the medic is really good just for keeping a disease down and out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially with local connections.
Yeah, medic is strong.
And then, I don't know, dispatcher, researcher...
Yeah, we were using dispatcher quite heavily last time to get people out of cities.
I think the dispatcher is still essential.
Yeah, so dispatcher, medic, colonel, quarantine specialist?
Yeah.
Sounds good to me.
I'm just going to take colonel again.
Yep.
Okay, I'm taking medic then.
I do love that we've all become attached to these characters now. That's going to hurt when one of them dies.
It's also like, you're not allowed to play my character. It's my character.
Which is funny because I'm playing the medic.
Which started as Ranico's character.
Because it's Ran Medic.
Yeah. How can you tell?
Because his name is just Rad Medic.
Why?
Okay. So starting location.
My vote Istanbul. For starting location would be Istanbul.
Yes.
Yeah. That seems sensible. It's reasonably close to North America.
Yeah.
We can easily move there.
It does also mean that the Colonel could then take a short flight to Atlanta, two rounds rapid, and fly back.
But we need to set up the base there first.
I would like to go to Chicago and set up a military base.
I just
don't want to hang around in Chicago.
We just have to. We could get across the border.
You could quarantine
their base,
and then you're safe.
Yeah, but as long as the Colonel goes and kills everything, then yes.
Yeah. So, I guess we roll to see who goes first, then, and then we plan from there.
Yep.
Wait, good roll. The dice isn't big enough.
Well, I rolled a 3.
Who rolled a 6?
Me.
Ha ha!
That's actually not as ideal as it could be, but eh.
Ooh, natural 20.
Boom! Natural 20, I go first.
Because, yeah, if I set up the base in Chicago, then the colonel the next turn can go and deal with that for me. Deal with the zombies for me.
Okay, so what do Medic do?
Where are we and where are the cubes? There's cubes in Bogota.
Hang on.
Yeah, I can't...
Yeah, the medic could get to Baghdad and clear Baghdad.
You can get to Sao Paulo and clear Bogota.
Because you can do from the adjacent cities.
I can fly to Buenos Aires and clear Bogota.
And Santiago.
No, that's... Yeah, oh, right.
No, wait, no. You can only do adjacent once per turn.
But he
I can only do adjacent
to...
once.
Clear Bogota, move to Santiago, clear Santiago.
Santiago's
or
got any cubes.
Or do the same thing with Bogota. It's got one cube.
Sorry, I couldn't
see that.
It
just blends in.
Yeah,
so I think that's decent. I fly to Buenos Aires. That's one action. And then action 2, I clear Bogota.
Yep.
Better to clear Santiago than move and clear Bogota. Because Bogota is a more convenient city to be in.
It's got better
lanes. Yeah, you're entirely right there.
Okay.
So there, that's 4 actions. Draw 2.
Just no.
Washington gets a zombie.
No epidemics.
Washington. Zombie on that. And
at least they don't cause outbreaks.
Istanbul.
Well, that's good.
Istanbul gets a zombie.
No, it's not blue, fortunately.
Only blue cards get. It's not quite that cruel.
Yeah.
Yet. You wait.
True. Johannesburg gets a cube.
Yeah, no problem.
And also Mexico City gets a zombie.
Yep. That's still fine.
And that's the end of medic turn.
Okay. How's about this for a strategy? I can take a direct flight to Atlanta. I have the card for Atlanta. So I could put the military base in Atlanta rather than in Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Unfortunately, I don't have... Don't you need a city to roadblock? You have to have that city card. It's just one action, isn't it?
Also, relevant, we forgot the May win bonus.
Oh yeah, we can put three little markers. Let's do that now.
I was thinking Cairo to Algiers, Istanbul to Cairo, and Istanbul to Baghdad.
Yep.
So, wait.
That pretty much walls off all exits
Algiers,
out of Europe
Cairo.
Then.
Yeah, now we just need to make sure that none of that
so
would
like
interfere
this?
With what I did.
Yeah, like that.
But I
you,
took
you
a
flew
flight,
out. You didn't cross a roadblock, so you're fine.
Yeah, fine. So that doesn't interfere.
So
cool.
Yeah, two actions to get to Atlanta, put a military base there. Third action would be to move to Miami. Fourth action, roadblock up Miami.
Yeah, just close all the exits. Seems Miami isn't fated? I thought it was.
Yeah, I would put it. Yeah, put it. Yeah, it's wall off Miami.
I mean, worst comes to worst, we just wall off Miami to Bogota. But
yeah,
walling off the rest. Yeah, would be pretty good.
No,
as
it's
well.
Basically just wall it off to all the faded cities.
Yeah. Given that it's faded as well, I would be tempted to wall it off to Bogota, but that does give
it
us a routine.
It doesn't have
in.
A faded marker.
Yeah, we just need to pop one on there.
Okay.
Wait, there I thought go. Miami wasn't faded.
I'm pretty sure it was.
No, I'm pretty sure it wasn't.
Check the footage.
I'm pretty sure like that was the one North American city that wasn't.
Oh, I didn't the think there were any America North was. American cities. That, yeah. I thought we had ceded the US to the zombies, much like we have Europe. Save for Moscow.
Yeah, save for Moscow, which is safely quarantined off.
Which still outbroke and caused me to get a scar because I couldn't flee. But, you know, I'm not bitter.
You know?
Only a little bit.
Just because you repeatedly said, maybe I should leave Moscow.
Yes. So, what do we think? Was Miami faded or not?
I'm trying to find...
Okay, say, if you head for the last 5 minutes of the video, that was where we were looking at the new stuff.
I think you should then not fade, but roadblock Miami to Bogota. I will quarantine that city in my turn.
Yep.
Yeah, but then how does he get out?
He goes to Mexico, of course.
So we just block that one. And
yeah, I don't think blocking anything more is of any use.
Yeah,
we do need to block the route.
We need to have free transport across some areas. So, mostly at this point, it's just stopping the outbreak of fading, so we don't get any more faded cities.
Yeah.
Even though it's already spread to Sao Paulo.
Yeah, but I mean, Sao Paulo is one vector that hopefully we can put a lid on.
Not necessarily
literally, but still.
That's why we just go and kill Sao Paulo.
Yeah. Hopefully, if we get past June, we start getting a couple more ways to fight back against the faded.
Hopefully. Maybe.
We just have to look forward to the when we get the literal new card.
Yeah.
I'm hoping for tanks myself. Well, like so, some sort
I'm
of artillery.
I'm hoping for Roadhog or Reinhardt.
San Fran gets a faded.
Oh, it goes up to 3. That's a problem.
Okay.
That's less than ideal, yeah.
And Cairo.
So we're having an outbreak situation in... We have three cities on 3.
They don't outbreak from this, do they?
No, they don't.
No, they don't. They can't outbreak from that, in fact. No, they can't even break quarantine if the card shows up in this.
Yeah, it's just okay. if one of these outbreaks, if we get an epidemic, then we are
infection
really
card?
Screwed. Karachi.
I see where it is, yep.
Lima.
Okay, cool. My turn then.
The rule only mentions that if this would place a fourth figure, it is ignored and not placed. No outbreak occurs and no quarantine marker is moved. It doesn't say that quarantine markers stay if there
quarantine markers
three.
Are only removed if a figure would be placed.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
So if they're two and a quarantine marker and someone draws a blue card, then the quarantine marker goes away.
Yeah, because a figure would be placed.
Yeah.
All right, moving on.
Right, quarantine here. Where's quarantine marker?
It's in one of the box, one of the things.
And quarantine one of these cities. Chicago?
Chicago, I think. Because we kind of want to keep Atlanta open if possible.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, and...
And I've quarantined Miami, so that means if any figures would be placed here, nothing happens.
Yep.
Yeah, and do remember that quarantining 7 faded cities is one of our objectives still.
Yeah, yes. And it's a mandatory objective.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
Only the cure objective is mandatory. Oh, right.
The red text is they just have to be in the city for it to count.
Cool. Yeah, it must be in place at the end of the game. Made
mandatory. Yeah, like it hasn't been, it isn't, they have to have been 7 cities quarantined.
Yeah.
All right. I get Milan. Milan gets a figure.
Where's Milan?
And we get an epidemic.
Oh,
well done.
Fun.
Well,
fun times.
There's a very large chance that the US is about to outbreak.
Don't forget to draw your extra final cards, Ranico.
Why?
Oh, no, sorry, yes, because it was your second one, sorry.
We take the bottom of this deck first.
It's alt right click.
Oh, right. You do that. You actually know how to tabletop sim.
Take it.
Kinshasa.
And Kinshasa is in the southern bit of Africa.
Lagos on top.
I'm more.
And then we die.
LA! Outbreak, 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 outbreak. Everything breaks.
Two outbreaks.
Oh no,
three, because to Chicago. Because the Fiddle first sticks. Outbreak from LA takes the quarantine marker off.
Wow.
Yep. Can we just review exactly how outbreaks work?
Okay, no, start.
See how this all works, okay?
No,
and quarantines.
This does work like this.
I'm pretty sure it does, but on the other hand...
Let's go to the rule book. I would like to double check. This seems... This is going to get complicated.
Mexico City would get 3. We ping the marker off Chicago. San Francisco then outbreaks, which triggers LA and Chicago to re-outbreak.
So once the city has outbreaked, it can't outbreak multiple times in one go, okay? Right. So otherwise, it's just an infinite loop and we lose.
So LA knocks the marker off Chicago. San Francisco outbreaks.
Panic levels.
San Francisco's outbreak triggers Chicago to outbreak. Chicago's outbreak can't re-trigger San Fran or LA, but it does trigger Mexico City to outbreak.
Move the outbreak marker, then place a disease cube of that color on each city connected to it. If any of them already has 3, don't place the cube. Instead, chain reaction occurs. So first, move the outbreaks marker, then place cubes as above, but don't put them on cities that have already had an outbreak or chain reaction outbreak as part of resolving the current infection card.
Yep. So, Los Angeles outbreaks. Let's go around in order clockwise. Yeah. San Fran would then outbreak. Chicago would outbreak, so it loses its quarantine marker.
Mm-hmm.
Would get infected, sorry.
And Mexico
gains its third.
Yeah.
We then resolve San Francisco. LA can't. There's roadblocks out
Chicago
the other side.
Can't.
So Chicago then outbreaks because it's then lost its quarantine marker.
Atlanta gets another one. Montreal gets one.
Yep, which means Atlanta, Montreal, and
Mexico
Lima,
City,
Bogota. Bogota as well. Fuck.
Because then Mexico City outbreaks.
Yeah.
Turns out Miami.
We
was
literally
the safe place,
did not have an opportunity to do anything about this.
No, it was a really bad setup.
Yeah, because Lamb's turn would have been the first turn we could do anything to.
Yeah, and he would have prevented a chain outbreak involving Chicago.
Yeah.
I think. Maybe not. But anyway,
so
everything is fucked.
Now we need to make sure that people do not get scars.
Yeah, so Lamb, your mission is probably going to be trying to get to Bogota.
He can just go through the roadblock, so that's okay. Baghdad also gets a third black cube.
Oh, we've lost Hub. Hub is waiting for Discord to resume working. Yeah. Okay, I didn't realize we'd lost Hub in that massive chain of outbreaks.
Well, everything broke, so it's not that surprising.
Yeah.
Okay. So as much as it would be nice to like clear up Atlanta, keep in mind that was just LA, right? San Francisco is still in that pile. Chicago is still in that pile. Mexico City is still in that pile.
Oh, we've already lost this chart like this month.
Oh, absolutely. There is no way.
There's absolutely nothing we can do about it. We have lost.
Yeah, there's something we can do about it to a certain extent. Roadblocks. Just roadblock off every one of those infected cities, and then we'll lose as it chain reacts, but we won't lose as badly.
Oh, let's raise the stuff on cities, by the way.
Yep, so Chicago goes up to 2.
It just raised by 1 level each.
Yep. Mexico City goes up to 3, doesn't it?
Atlanta gets 1.
Yep.
No, Atlanta didn't outbreak.
No.
No, you're right.
So, F off.
Mexico City now full on rioting.
No, they went 2.
Oh, right, sorry. Yeah, so everything's up to done. 2 now.
I really wish there was a way we could roadblock Atlanta and still save Hub.
No. And I think saving Hub is probably more of a priority. We've already lost this.
I can fly to Lagos, walk to Hub, and kill the zombie.
Yeah.
That's 4 moves.
Okay.
Either that or without discarding.
That doesn't stop Atlanta from getting the problem.
You can still walk. You don't need to discard. You can fly to Atlanta, walk down to Bogota,
and then walk down to Bogota. Okay. Yeah. I mean, saving Hub is straightforward, right?
Yeah.
The thing that I would really like to be able to do is to save Atlanta.
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
From losing the research station.
We can't do anything. That's not going to happen until it starts collapsing.
Until a double
flipping over Chicago is what's going to trigger that. So.
Yeah. But what will happen is it will go to unstable. It won't go to rioting, which is when we actually lose Atlanta.
Yeah.
No, it's at not even at rioting yet. I think it's at collapsing. You lose it.
No, it's rioting.
You lose your research station at rioting.
It's also no direct flights in or out, which is it's one of the last few places we can hop into. America might right now.
Yeah. But as I said, we can't save Atlanta. Like
no, I understand. I agree.
Well, we can if we can survive round to Hub's next to Ranico's next turn, because we can put some quarantine markers in. But I think Lam, your priority right now is save Hub.
Yeah, which I'm gonna do.
There was just nowhere I could put a quarantine marker to resolve that triangle of doom.
Well, unless you'd picked exactly which of the three were going to cause the problem.
Yes, obviously.
But all of the three are going to cause the problem because the rest of them are still in the pile.
Yes.
Yeah. Come on, Hub.
So yeah, Hub thinks there might be a max limit on the number of cities with panic markers. I think there's enough for one for each city.
Yeah, no, there isn't a limit.
No, I think he means the limit on how many can be placed per turn. Remember, there's the 8 limit.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, isn't the game is immediately over when we hit 8 outbreaks.
We're halfway there.
Next turn, if we draw one of these cities, we will hit that because we will have 5 outbreaks.
It's okay. I exist again.
Woohoo!
You do. There we go.
Right, so Lam is going to save you.
I'm going to fly to Atlanta. And then I'm going to walk to Bogota and kill the zombie.
And then you're not going to turn over San Francisco or Chicago.
Yeah,
or Mexico.
Lam, draw your cards.
I don't wanna.
Lam, draw your cards. This bit's fine.
Chessa.
It's the infect stage that Sydney. Will ruin it.
Okay.
Beijing.
That's fine. Sure. Karachi. Okay.
That's also fine.
Alright, Hub. Now you will ruin us.
Road block the shit out of everything.
Okay, so roadblocks where?
Drop a roadblock between Mexico City and Bogota.
He can't. He has to go to Mexico. Roadblock.
No, I can roadblock things.
No, because South America doesn't have
a military base. But what
but
you could
if
do,
he goes
actually,
to Mexico, he could quarantine it. Or does he need the Mexico City card to quarantine?
He can quarantine the city he's in. He can also roadblock every entrance to Mexico other than the one to Miami, quarantine it, and leave.
Yeah, I can do that. 1, 2, 3, leave. Yeah.
Yeah, and you get to choose whether you go back to Bogota or head for the safety of Miami.
I'm going to head for the safety of Miami because, yeah.
You can't get zombies in Miami. It's zombie-proof.
Yeah, so quarantine Mexico City because, yeah.
And then roadblock everything.
Roadblock. Do I want to roadblock to LA as well?
Yeah.
Yes.
Because we
you
don't
want to roadblock to both LA and
loops.
Chicago.
We're trying to limit panic markers at this point.
There, and then I just leave.
Yeah. Yep. I mean, we still leave. So not leave. We still lose. If you draw San Francisco or Chicago, which, by the way, it's your own fact step, so have fun.
Yeah, first, though, player cards.
London gets a zombie.
Hello, London.
We've only got 18 faded left.
Yeah, we're going to lose this hard.
Oh, yeah.
Sao Paulo, that's fine. Sao Paulo gets a zombie.
No, it doesn't. It's not blue. The card's not blue.
Oh, no, yeah. Ah.
Not in infect step.
Not
yeah.
in infect.
Now
no.
it's infect.
Now it's infect. Lima?
Lima.
That's
gets
okay.
A zombie.
Oh, it's got a zombie and. Doesn't the cube transition to a zombie?
No, not one of those.
So it's just got cubes and zombies.
Yep. And next?
Next step.
Tokyo.
Okay. We live at least a while still.
Okay. Keep. Save Atlanta.
Yep. That's pretty much it. I've got to go into Atlanta, quarantine Atlanta, and back out again, pretty much, haven't I?
Quarantine roadblock.
What you could do is you could... Are you? So you're in Miami. So
yeah.
You could go to Atlanta, quarantine, roadblock. The question is, you could go to Atlanta, and you could roadblock off two of the roads.
Yes.
Right? Then you could go to Chicago, and you could roadblock off Chicago. Then you could move back to Miami using your dispatcher powers.
That's five actions.
Move, roadblock, move, roadblock. You're right, it is five actions. Damn. I thought I was being clever. The other option is go straight to Chicago and roadblock.
And roadblock
and
Chicago. Because I don't think Atlanta's
in
the pile.
Completely isolate Chicago. Yeah, it isn't in the pile yet.
Because then I can, I can just walk back to any other player, can't I?
Yes.
Does that count as a direct flight?
Nope. It's a dispatcher power.
Oh, yes, it is.
It's just move your player to another player.
Yep.
The dispatcher is just straight up magic.
Okay, so Chicago. Do we just want to roadblock Well, we don't need to roadblock Montreal, do we?
I would roadblock everything, because then it doesn't even count as an outbreak.
Well, it counts as an outbreak. He just doesn't go
anywhere.
It
just means Chicago will go up. That's why I don't think it's too bad breaking out to Montreal. It gives us then a safe route in if we need it.
Yeah, because
I think I would rather just rely on discarding a blue card.
The only one that needs to get in there is me.
And he
I can just walk out of Roblox.
Okay. How many Roblox will we have left after this?
Oh, 7. You can only place 3, so...
Ah, so yeah.
Montreal will still be...
And then...
No.
Back to Miami.
You may spend one action to place Roblox on as many routes as you want out of your current city.
The 3 is at the end. We get to keep 3.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In which case, I actually suggest it's the 3 we placed at the start.
Probably, yeah. That helps just wall off Europe.
Yeah.
I love how we're just roadblocking off everything in North America now.
Well, it's
the only option.
What the fuck do you expect?
It's the only thing we can do to make sure things don't get worse before we lose. Because we're going to lose.
We now won't lose with a single card draw.
Soul and Lima for me.
You brought the cube for your
Oops.
Eyes. You monster.
There we go.
Worst part of this is that we are stuck in the freaking city, like in the zombie-ridden U.S.
Yeah, we're all just hanging out in Miami in a quarantine tent somewhere.
It's not the best place to be. But on the other hand, it's better than Chicago.
I mean, arguably, since...
I mean, if you can get back to Atlanta, we could start equipping some cities, but good luck with that.
I mean, arguably, since we've got a quarantine marker and the quarantine specialist, this is the safest place on the entire board. It is the
safest place,
just built a bubble around ourselves, and we're fine.
Well, no one's breaking this quarantine.
If we're fine... Next turn, I can go and kill Atlanta.
Yeah.
Well, you can kill. Yeah, you could. No, you can only kill 2.
No, I can 3.
He's in the right.
I'm not in Bogota.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna quarantine Atlanta and then get the hell out of there.
Well, I can only kill one then because I'll also need to get out of Atlanta because I don't want to be in Atlanta.
So quarantining Atlanta, are you going to remote quarantine?
Go and clear Mexico City, actually.
Yeah, that's what's
my turn. My turn, I'm going to go Atlanta, quarantine. I'll look at remotely quarantining something else. But we'll see. Okay, Atlanta, quarantine. Istanbul, quarantine somewhere else. Yes, that seems sensible. Okay, quarantine San Fran.
Yep. Yeah, I think our best bet right now is to disarm all the cities that will instantly kill us.
Yep.
Which is why I'm going to go kill Mexico City.
Yep. Yeah. Okay, so you've run away to Europe where it's safe.
I'm still on the wrong side of the roadblock. Thank you very much.
And Baghdad is looming as well. Okay.
Now I draw. Epidemic! Everybody's favorite cards. It's my turn to ruin everything.
Okay, where's Ho Chi Minh? That's fine.
Well, so I think it's at least time for Hob to get out of America.
Yeah.
And start dealing with stuff like Baghdad.
Yeah. Hey, Stephanie, so you're watching Lima. Us lose in spectacular fashion.
Lima just went up to 3 zombies.
Oh, Lima, why you have to be like that? Should I go kill...
LA just outbroke. Which by the
San
way,
Fran.
Results in a chain outbreak. San Fran got quarantined, so that's not a big deal.
It outbreaks Lima.
But it outbreaks Lima, which is a big deal.
Fuck. Yeah, because
this just went up to 2.
Yeah, I'm taking a scar.
Yep.
Santiago's faded.
Oh crap! Yeah, because so it's now about to be your turn.
We're just gonna lose yellow now.
Yeah, like, yellow's fucked. We can't do anything.
Okay, so San Fran loses its quarantine.
Yeah.
The good thing about losing a color is it becomes trivial to eradicate.
True.
Lima goes up to 3.
Yep. I already put Los Angeles up to 3, so...
And that's it for a given value of it.
I'm tempted, because I'm going to take a scar now. I'm tempted to instead, as my turn, run to São Paulo and Buenos Aires and roadblock those so we can have them as our permanent roadblocks.
You can't, unless you can put down a card to build a station.
Yeah. Ranico, did you draw the epidemic as your first or second card?
It was my first card.
So you do need to draw a second.
Correct. Bangkok.
Sorry, just had a bearing because we're running out of faded figures.
Yeah, absolutely.
So what scar are you going to take then, Lam?
Let's go look in the scar bag, see what we have.
Something cool, something decorative.
We have things in the scar bag.
I suggest overcautious.
I'm already not going to be discovering cures with this character.
Oh, because he takes 2 extras, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, and so overcautious means 3 extra.
He's just not going to do anything anyways. That's not the scar I chose.
Yeah, you took the wrong one out of the bag.
Put back in bag. Right, put back in bag.
Yeah, you definitely don't want to take terror.
Oh, but I know what. I've got a search running.
Yeah, it's because everyone's searching.
Okay, that's all sorted now.
There we go. Now we have all cautious.
And then just a sort of a scar wobbling around there.
Yeah, let's put it back in the bag.
I can't actually click on it.
I can't select it. Yeah, okay, great.
Alright, so I'm scarred. Let's make sure I don't get scarred more. Alright, what's our movements? Kill Lima, make sure this doesn't get worse. No, it's already gotten worse. Lima's already... Fuck, South America is just lost cause.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, we only need 2 more outbreaks to wreck us, so...
So try and limit where they can outbreak to.
I'm going to South America and fucking build a military base.
Could you quarantine Lima?
Then I can't build a military base in South America and roadblock.
Well, that's the thing, is if you quarantine Lima, that kind of makes it safe. And then you could run back to Bogota and kill the dude in Bogota.
1, 2, 2, dead. There.
Yeah, I mean, I think in the long run, roadblocks between Sao Paulo and Johannesburg and Buenos Aires, and we're literally abandoning America.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. All of the Americas.
Yeah. And then America and Europe then will be just walled off from the rest of the world.
And then it's time for things we don't want to draw.
Super happy fun times.
Nothing happens there. Fine.
Yeah. Yep.
Infection times. Do we lose?
That is the question. Lose,
or do we win?
Jimin
outbreaks.
Yeah.
So that takes us to 7.
Yep. And Ho Chi Minh is now unstable. And next.
Baghdad. We lose.
Outbreaks. And we lose.
Baghdad goes to
unrest, and that's it.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it. There's no point in doing anything else.
That's June 1.
However,
at the end of the first game, before selecting upgrades, open W and then draw this card.
W contains a rule on equipment.
Ooh.
Ooh.
So we can just upgrade city cards with equipment at the end of the game.
That seems pretty sweet. Let's do that.
Do we want that, or do we want our wall around Europe?
We can do...
Wall around Europe
We get two, don't we? So that's just one,
yeah,
isn't it?
We can do two. So we can do Europe and three upgrades.
That seems pretty strong.
Because South America is already lost now, so there's no point in making those permanent.
Yeah, the permanent ones need to be the cross-ocean ones now. And we don't even need to worry about Sao Paulo to Madrid. It's Sao Paulo to Lagos, Buenos Aires to Johannesburg, and then that's it.
All right, let's get some permanent equipment.
Yeah, leaving just Africa, Asia, and the Pacific Rim as the safe zones.
Also, Lam inadvertently cheated in that game. He can't kill zombies in Bogota.
Oh, yeah, I can't. Well, it didn't matter because we lost on my turn.
Yeah,
I know.
Why couldn't he kill... Oh, because he needs the military base. To kill zombies.
Yeah, but like as I said, it doesn't matter because that was the last thing it did and we lost.
Yeah.
And we didn't lose due to these guys outbreaking.
Yeah.
Right. What do we want to get from the equipment?
Oh, and I will point out that I didn't cheat because my scar is cubes of the same color, not faded. So I can hop in and out.
We can get a hazmat suit, we can get a grenade belt.
I think, given the number of faded cities, getting some grenade belts in place is going to be pretty useful.
Yes, definitely. Grenade belt on like all of the blue cards.
We can get an induced pluripotent stem cell, which lets us use a card as any color when finding a cure.
Yes, that one I think is essential, and probably on a blue card again.
Yeah, so a grenade belt, and I think a hazmat suit.
Yeah.
That prevents scars from a zombie once?
Yes.
Yeah, that also seems good, especially since we're getting more scars, because zombies.
All right, what cities do we want to add these to? There are, I suppose, all blue.
All blue.
Chicago, Essen, and Milan.
Yeah, why not?
I say because they happen to be the three blue cards that were in my hand.
I have London and Washington in case we want to...
Chicago, Washington definitely. Also, bear in mind that we can't discard these ones to fly to these cities.
Yeah.
Anything that's a two. So, Chicago, San Fran, Montreal...
Whoops.
Essen,
Chicago, and Milan are literally all riding.
Yeah.
They are literally... useless cards right now.
Yeah.
Well, that's not true. You can use them to build military bases.
There we go. Where do we put these so we know they exist? Let's put them over here.
Yeah, if you put them and then put a note next to them to say
and
which cities they're attached
to.
And
also put a note on these
cards. If you hover over, they'll say.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, can you not attach them to...
No.
Why not?
We can't edit the cards, so...
We'd have to make a custom texture for the cards.
Yeah.
So we're just going to have them here.
Okay, which one gets what?
I have all the dates.
Okay, yeah. I know, but I can modify the Essen card description to say it has hazmat.
Yeah.
Essen is hazmat.
Milan is which?
Milan is grenade belt. It doesn't have to say... No, because there we go.
I added them to the descriptions, so if you hover over a while, it tells you what they are.
Yeah, I'm also just adding it to the name, because that way you don't even need to hover over it as long. And it doesn't happen when it's in a stack, but it does happen now.
Yep. I'm afraid I'm not going to have time to play a second game tonight, so that's going to be where we have to end, unfortunately.
That's okay. Oh, well. I should sleep.
I had hoped we'd get two games in, but I kind of need to finish off writing up this sample code and get it over to the recruiters, so.
Yeah, okay. That's cool. And it's easily the most stumped on I have been in one of these games, but yeah. Just having two cities start in fully infected and them being zombie cities is just lethal.
Particularly as close as they were with that feedback loop.
Did we pick our second game and upgrade? We get two, don't we?
We were going to do permanent roadblocks. These
permanent roadblocks, so they need to actually be made permanent.
Let's add those.
I'll add those. So, boop. And one more.
There's a... There it is.
I'm enjoying my giant ball of floating zombies.
Zombie ball. You missed three, by the way.
Oh, yeah, on Mexico City.
Zombie Battlesphere.
Okay, what else is there to do? I'll just move that back. Keep in mind that we have our funding increased by two, so we can actually have some shit, including remote outposts, which could be helpful. Probably not. I think it's probably better to get the things that let us avoid infections or...
Yeah.
All right, just
deal with zombies.
Europe is just walled off now.
Yep.
Yeah.
As I say, if we can get those
great wall.
If we can get those transatlantic roadblocks in place, then we're good.
It's obviously admittedly we still need to do outbreak where management. I want to draw the line, but it's where we've got to draw the line.
Yeah, it's kind of forced our hand.
Like, why did they all end up in there? Keep in mind that we will have four yellow cities. So yellow will become very quick to eradicate.
Yeah.
But we're going to get a lot of infected markers.
We were so close to getting a handle of South America, and then everything fucked.
Yeah. And everything occurred.
Yeah. Like that.
We're going to build a big wall to keep the zombies out.
And then we'll make the zombies pay for it.
When the zombies come to take our jobs.
Okay. Well, no, actually, just come to eat us. The fact that the wall is in Europe and is blocking out the Middle East kind of makes that uncomfortable.
A bit, yeah.
Yeah, but the Middle East is the good side of it, so, you know.
Yeah,
that's true, actually. It's the other way around.
I'm pretty sure it's the Middle East that blocks.
Pretty sure they have currently got a bit of a refugee crisis.
Yeah, pretty much. They're not used to it with people going the other way. There's people swimming from Italy across the Mediterranean to Africa. So yeah, that's looking like a bit of a disaster zone, really, isn't it?
This whole board is sort of looking like a disaster.
This board is looking like a disaster zone. I'm pretty sure that's
the point of this game.
More cities being unstable than being stable. Yeah.
Which is why I'm expecting, was we're at the halfway point with June.
Yeah.
The difficulty will probably continue to spike, but in a different way. Instead of being overwhelming odds, you'll start getting more tools to deal with them, like the grenade belts and things, because at the moment there's been very little we can do against the faded stuff, and I think that's the point. You get a couple of months where the faded just spreads uncontrollably, and then they start giving you those tools to get it under control.
So the first thing we do next month is use this to block off the Atlantic.
That's true, actually. We just straight up block these, and I don't think we block this one.
Yeah, and we block don't need that one, but...
And then we just,
I think we block one of the things in one of the triangles to make it less of a triangle.
We'll see what kind of infection setup we get next game.
Yeah, and I'm also pretty sure we should probably tag in the soldier next turn.
Yeah, it's definitely double military now. Absolutely.
Technically, it's triple military because the quarantine is also military.
Oh, well, we and got wrecked.
Keep in mind that one of the first things we are going to need is military bases in this area.
Yeah, we're probably going to have to keep an eye on getting a permanent military base somewhere in North or South America.
Yep. I recommend Bogota.
Yep.
Or Atlanta. Seems these.
Atlanta is the, like, only... Oh, wait, no, Washington is still on... Oh, wait,
New York is still pretty chill.
Still on face.
New York is like, we don't give a shit about this zombie outbreak. We're City Sarah. Look, we played the division,
okay.
Yeah, New York just... No, they don't care. Santiago also oddly chill about the whole thing, as is Atlanta. But Atlanta's got the CDC, so I think they're probably fine.
I mean, aside from Europe and America, most of the world is pretty calm about this situation.
That's the thing. We really only started getting a lot of rioting cities as the faded started spreading.
Yeah.
And I think that's kind of deliberate because we didn't have the tools to deal with it. You just had to let it outbreak.
Yeah, the best we could do is quarantine.
So, yeah. We will hopefully stream our next game of this. We're not quite sure yet when it will be. I know there's some people haven't got much availability next week. So.
Yeah, we'll see because I'm going on a holiday next Thursday and I'll need to, like... And then straight after the holiday, my parents are visiting. So there's a certain amount of packing and cleaning that will need to be done.
Yep.
Next week on Tuesday, I'm moving back to my hometown for summer, probably. So I'll have a laptop, so I can still pandemic from there. But with summer job being a thing, yeah. Scheduling is going to be interesting.
We'll keep playing this. If it's convenient stream times, we'll stream. Hopefully the
but
stream
it is
tonight...
possible that the next June game will take place in June.
Yes, highly likely at this point. Hopefully this stream has been pretty stable for... Mega Dice. Been pretty stable for everybody.
It seems to actually be still up, so that's a plus.
Yeah, that's better than last time. Future streams, I think I will probably be looking at bumping the quality up to 720 and seeing how it handles. Because it seems to have done okay tonight, which is good.
This is what we need about America. We just need to get a big diest.
You are aware that's bigger than the moon. So that's a pretty good equivalent to just slamming the moon into the earth.
Can you imagine... If the next thing that happens in the game is that we get an alien invasion,
just replace black or red with an alien invasion and go nuts.
I mean, called the Red Menace.
Carve a D20 from the moon. That seems like a very sensible plan.
No, we can't because it's a dragon egg.
Oh right, no, obviously.
Shut up. We don't talk about that.
We don't talk about that.
Normally we only do when we want to rile can't wear hats.
I don't get
well, that dice is gone forever.
I feel that still happened because someone watched Game of Thrones. So when they were talking about that in like the first episodes and he was like, that's a really good idea. Well, you ruined it.
I don't know where the dice is. Oh, it's in space.
It's in orbit.
Forever.
Right.
Goodbye forever.
And hopefully this time around, we won't misplace the save files.
Yeah,
lamb.
This is properly saved now.
Yep.
Back it up in a place more than one place.
Oh, Tesla's come to say hi.
I thought I did, which was the annoying thing. I remember putting it in my Dropbox.
Well, do you have Dropbox history thing?
I don't know.
It's like the default Dropbox file history is like a month or something. You can just look back at files.
So for anybody in chat, that's exclamation point Tesla for a Tesla appearance on stream. And there we go. I really should change it to be exclamation point Kitty, but yeah, it is what it is. So yeah, thank you very much for playing, gents, and maybe next time we won't lose quite so badly.
Yeah. Also, I just noticed
that if we lose 8 games in a row, we get to draw open mysterious package number 8.
Yep.
Yeah.
4 games in a row, actually. We only need to lose this month and next month.
Yep.
I just noticed the pings we have. Ranico's pig is pretty dope.
Is?
Oh, you can't see them?
For some reason, it's not telling me.
Oh, no. Rana's ghost ping is 10.
Fun times.
Mine is about 53, so...
Mine's hovering around 60.
Mine's showing is 9.
Yeah, there you go.
Dang, son. Dang.
That's not bad.
How happens we practically live an hour away from each other?
Yeah. Yeah, get something
takes
like
2 hours by brain.
Get something like somebody like HP Braincase with his corn-fed organic American internet in here.
Oh God, no! Please no.
Dear, his internet is certainly a thing.
It exists most of the time.
Mine is good because our what used to be the national telecommunications agency. And it's still kind of the primary company that deals with putting all the pipes and the wires in. Their main research base is in this town. So it's in their interest to hook up high-speed internet to large portions of it because that's where most of their staff live.
Dope.
So that works out fairly well for me.
I just live in, like, one of the bigger cities in Finland, so I have decent internet.
Yes, because your country's had a sensible attitude towards internet and did a really good job of getting high-speed internet pretty quickly.
Yeah, I mean, overall, internet prices are worse here than they are in Sweden, but otherwise we've got about the same quality of internet.
Mine is included in my strata fees, so I don't actually know how much it costs.
I know my sister, who lives up in northern Sweden, pays like 150 a month or something for her fiber
internet. Northern Sweden's quite remote, isn't it? So it kind of makes...
When you say 150, do you mean US or?
I mean Swedish fancy money.
That changes completely.
That's
how much
like
150 is.
$20 US.
Yeah,
it's like 14, 15 US dollars equivalent.
Yeah. Bear in mind that I currently pay about £40 a month for my internet.
I pay 10. No, I pay 0. I have free internet.
In Australia, I was paying about $90 a month for my net, I think. I don't know. It was paid for by work.
I pay about $20.
Could pay
£20 is about average, because I've got the fast, high speed, unlimited internet. Costs a little bit more.
I've only got 50 over 50, and that's free. If I wanted 100 over 100, I'd have to pay $10 a month for it.
I'm just going to move a little bit off this map here. Because I'm just going to point out to Jekowo and Navarin when I was talking about on Sunday Ezra in the Georgia system. Well, as you may have noticed there, Ezra in the Georgia system has a giant label saying Niska above it on the map.
Okay, this has been Pandemic Legacy.
Yep. Now it isn't Pandemic Legacy, now it's Firefly.
It is now Firefly, yes.
You're just flicking things around the game board.
Yeah.
Oh, hey.
Oh, there's Bellerophon and there's Bellerophon. So, yeah, people can see where we... I actually need to get a decent map for our RPG streams to put in the background instead of just our corkboard. I might steal this.
Yeah, it's worth stealing. It's a pretty good map.
Ah, that's fun. Look, my tiny face. Ah, and now I'm okay. Moving the wrong parts of the overlay.
Depart. I will see you gentlemen when we next schedule a game.
Yes.
Indeed.
Yep, see you in the future.
Yep.
Future!
And maybe some bonus streams for me in the week. We will see. But yeah, Potato Comp, it's alive! Thank you all very much for watching, and see you another time.
Bye. I'm out.